Rigo.
Velvet! You're really all right.
Oh, thank heavens! It's so good to see you!
Where have you been all this time? You never even wrote!
But I don't. I thought the whole village was wiped out that day.
Yeah. It nearly was.
But just when we thought it was all over, Arthur, Lord Artorias, saved us!
No, it was his doing in the first place! He sacrificed Lopiset!
It really was a shame what happened to that poor boy.
That's all you have to say? A shame? My brother Lopi died
that- I'm sorry. Truly, I am. But you can't lose hope, dear.
He's right. What counts is that your brother's still alive.
He's alive?
He's in your house. Don't worry, we've all pitched in to take care of him.
I don't...
Velvet...
This is not good.
Velvet, let's go to your house and see.
Yeah, okay.
Insane. That's freaky, man.
Luffy. Luffy's alive?
What's wrong?
Well, that didn't break it.
Next time you suspect an illusory art, test out your theory on yourself.
You think we're all seeing an illusion?
It's possible. It wouldn't be the first time.
But an entire village? That shouldn't be possible.
Shouldn't be, no.
How do we approach this? Try to break it apart at the seams somehow?
No. For now, we and our enemies share the same goal. Come on, help me look for the Therian.
Sure.
I think I'll stick with Velvet.
I won't stop you.
Keep a close eye on her. I don't think she's entirely right in the head at the moment.
Yeah.
He has to punch on the scene. Like how he punched though. Knowing how powerful his punches are.
My home. It hasn't changed a bit.
We need to be careful, Velvet. Aizen thinks this could be a trap.
You think Nico and everyone are being controlled?
I don't know. It's just...
You think it could be Melchior's doing. But even so... It's not going to work on me.
You're insane. People can fight against pain, but...
I won't be deceived by this.
You'll open your wound!
You're warm! Luffy! You're really alive! Luffy?
He's been asleep. Ever since that day. I found him at the shrine. Collapsed on the ground. His wounds healed, but... He's never woken up.
We fell
if
in
he's
the
still
shrine.
Alive, that's all that matters. I'll find a way to wake you again, Luffy. I swear I will. We'll be together. I still have to thank you for this comb, after all.
So, that's where Velvet's comb came from.
Looked like something. He saw something.
Did Lord Artorias really try to sacrifice such a defenseless child?
What's wrong, Lafayette? You don't look like your usual perky self.
I'm okay. I'm just glad Velvet's all right.
What? Your name is Lafayette too? What a weird coincidence!
Yeah.
Hey, sorry about all that, you guys.
Don't worry about it. What are we going to do now?
If it were me, I'd make Lafayette something he really likes for dinner tonight. He can handle soup.
Maybe he'll notice the smell of your cooking and it'll wake him up.
Yeah, maybe I should. Would you watch after him while I go buy what I need?
Of course. I am at your beck and call.
Is there anything I can do to help too?
Yes, please. I'll need you to be my taste tester.
This is not good. It's not good at all. Whoa, we lost everything. We lost everything in the fight.
All right.
I wonder if they've located the Therian.
Let's just leave that to them.
You're not curious?
Of course I am. But for right now, I want to stay close to Velvet. I've got a really bad feeling about this.
Something more important than finding the Therian?
Yeah. My stomach is twisted, and I've got a chill up my spine. I'm really scared.
Very well. I trust your feelings. We'll leave the Therian to Rokuro and Aizen, and stay with Velvet then.
Thanks, Eleanor.
Mogilu, what will you do?
Whatever I feel like.
I shouldn't have asked.
Thanks anyway, Mogilu.
Are you sure you're doing the right thing?
In the end, whatever happens, happens. Wiser words never spoken, right?
Holy shit, she getting serious. This is getting scary. Oh my goodness, I don't like this.
Flower.
I don't like this little bitch, Arena. But he's following that shrine. Yeah, I've been asking weird questions too. But I saw him fall through the shrine. And even got eaten up by some demon thing.
It's been a long time, hasn't it, Velvet? I wanted to apologize to you for ages now.
Apologize? What for?
That business with Arthur. Back then, I said he seemed like a fraud. I know you took it pretty hard. But if he wasn't there 3 years ago, our village would have been destroyed. I'm sorry I doubted him.
I didn't trust him then either. I only realized how amazing of a person he was when he saved all of our lives. I'm ashamed of myself. All this time we've been feeling terrible, thinking we may have driven you to leave the village. Please, forgive us.
That's not... I didn't...
Where have you been these past 3 years? It must have been tough living on your own, without any family to help you. Sorry, you don't have to talk about it if it hurts. But if you ever feel like talking, we're here for you.
I know we can't make up for all the pain we put you through, but if there's anything we can do, just ask. And if you'd like, you're always welcome to come back. The whole village would welcome you with open arms.
Okay, is this some type of joke or something? I can't wait for that. Look at him just standing there. Mm-hmm. I'm trying not to get near the...
Between the cold, the famine, and the demon blight, there were times I thought the world was done for. But over the past 3 years, I've stopped worrying.
I know we're overly reliant on Arthur and the Exorcists, but this village has changed. The Exorcists taught us that there are things the demons hate. We can't defeat them, but we can keep them away.
It's peaceful now. Exorcists stop by on patrol every now and then, and we haven't had a case of demon blight since what happened to your sister was horrible. But you and Lafayette should try to move on. Make the most of your lives.
I hope he wakes up soon.
I'm sure he will.
to move on. You can't tell other people to move on. They need to do that themselves. I mean, aren't they, were they already moving on when she died anyway?
Velvet, it's been forever. Great to see you. You haven't changed a whit.
What do you mean by that?
Have you seen Nico yet?
I have.
She's as full of life as she always was, right? Come to think of it, nothing's really changed much, has it?
I suppose not. By the way, how are Orthy and Russ doing?
Those pups haven't changed a whit either. They saw a guy with a big sword walking with a dour-eyed fellow in black. They freaked out and hightailed it.
That would be Rokuro and Aizen.
Those dogs are as cowardly as always.
So, what part of Velvet hasn't changed a whit?
She doesn't have any makeup on?
Uh-huh.
Feel like she's still hot.
The coming of the Malakim are a gift from the Imperians, a reward for our repentance and our renewed prayers. The Malakim are our blades against the demons, and the Exorcists the hands that wield them. Humanity's hope.
You never change. Want me to take you home this time?
No! Don't treat me like I'm senile!
Okay.
Oh! It's you, Velvet. Be careful when fighting prickle boars.
If they charge you, punch them in the nose, right?
No! Throw sand in their eyes!
Sand in the eyes. Got it.
You finally started listening to me. You're 16. You've really grown.
Yeah.
16? But aren't you 19?
Leave her be.
Yeah, why ask a question? That was a freaking old woman. Hey, grandmas get ages mixed up all the time.
I like how you both look in the opposite direction.
Hey, could I get some eggs, milk, spinach, and tomatoes? And I'd love to know what cheese you'd recommend, too.
You got it. And in celebration of your homecoming, I won't even charge. With you cooking up a feast like that, I'm sure Lafayette will wake up straight away.
Thanks. I really appreciate it.
You're getting spinach? I can't really handle it myself.
You'll never grow up strong if you don't eat your spinach, young lady.
I've done just fine without it so far, thank you.
Oh, if you insist, I'll leave it out just this once.
Wow, Velvet, you must be special. Not many folks get to be friends with an exorcist.
She's not my friend.
The way you two bicker, I find that hard to believe.
Oh, yeah. Do you have any prickle boar?
Oh, I'm sorry to say that I'm out at the moment.
That's fine. I'll hunt some up myself in the tranquil woods. Just like old times.
Actually, there haven't been any prickle boars there lately. You should try the Morgana Woods instead.
Okay, I'll do that. Thanks for the tip.
You don't like spinach, right, Eleanor?
Well, you know, I just... All right, it's true, but keep that between us, okay?
Velvet really seemed to be enjoying herself at the shop.
Quite. And she can really pick out a nice balance of foods while making every gulp count. She seems so cheerful and carefree.
That's the real Velvet. I'm sure of it.
Yes. An ordinary, dutiful, loving sister.
I wish she could have stayed that way. She could have lived a happy life, surrounded by her friends.
Just plain Velvet Crow, sister to Lord Artorias.
And maybe not Lord Artorias, but just plain Arthur.
A happy, ordinary life for an ordinary girl, with a kind family and supportive friends. Alrighty, to the Morgana Woods to hunt some prickle boars.
Yeah, sure.
Where the hell at it then?
The wizard came out of it.
Oh. Doit.
I'll finish this now. Stop fooling around.
Looks the best. Next thing you're through, you're going to use it on yourself.
What?
Oh, like the part where he punched. He said, next thing you're through,
we're looking for prickle boars. Keep your eyes on the thickets.
I'm not looking for your punk butts. I got those. I like how they got those. We used to be cooks or something, yeah. But now we're demons.
I'll finish this now.
Come on, put up some fight, okay?
This is hunting?
We keep this up, and who knows how many we'll bring home.
Wait, that was it? Oh, look how we gotta keep going. Oh shit. Would it be a good idea to beat that thing without the other two?
We will need to be extremely wary.
Blast away the shadows of darkness!
No mercy!
Wounds that won't heal! Scars in the flesh!
Rending flash, tear in there!
Blind
flash! Gaze upon my fiery mirror! Kaleido threat! Dark red!
Now, rise! Arise! Ascending! Angel!
Black is shooting star!
Blast away the shadows!
Wow, you're all about to get a left closer!
So evil!
You're all about to get a lot closer!
Fuck it!
Blinding high! You're all about to get a lot closer!
Would it like that? Funny. Just look how big, huge board he just beat the shit out of.
I'll finish this now.
I'm not one to go easy.
So you go in and back. Yeah, was that the same time we were doing them? Yeah, it was the same one we got there first one. Well, let's try their theory out, Rita. Oh. See? Came back again.
I'll finish this now.
Come on, put up some fight, okay?
Okay, this should be enough. Huh? What's wrong?
Nothing. I just feel a little sorry for them is all.
I hear you. These prickle boars might have all been family. People can be so heartless.
Yeah, I'd forgotten this feeling. But what can you do? At the end of the day, we have to eat just as much as they do.
Yes, what can you do in this situation indeed?
Luffy's waiting for us. We should run on home now.
Luffy.
I think I need to calm down. We're just skateboarding. Or hoverboarding. I need to be jealous. You got something cool, you guys don't. I'm drunk driving now, but you know.
Shopping, hunting, laughing with friends. That was how our life used to be, wasn't it?
Yes. It reminds me of my own past.
Huh? But wasn't your village... I'm sorry.
It's not your fault. The happy times I shared with my family, I still treasure those memories. And even after the attack, I've still been able to find happiness. Eating a good meal, making new friends...
And falling in love?
Yes, falling in...
Love?
Look what you made me say, Bianfu!
There's nothing to be ashamed of. Most every girl's happiest memories are of her first love, after all. Don't you think there was someone special out there Velvet had feelings for?
A first love? Do you really think so?
That's enough of that talk, Bianfu. You sound like an old man.
No! I'm only 150 years old and already being treated like an old man!
But still, I would like to meet the guy Velvet first fell for.
I wouldn't.
Oh, Jill.
I see. You're a guy.
No, I don't think she had anybody. Yeah, it was her friend who had a crush or had a... He wasn't even thinking about love. Mm-hmm. That her and her brother would have little picky fights with each other about girlfriend and boy. I think you need an older woman. You can't have a lot of these younger women these days. Take the eye patch on her. I always like her eyes.
Heard the news about your brother. I'm happy for you. So, what's your plan now?
You guys were snooping around the village.
Yeah, we wanted to check out that shrine too, but we got stopped. Apparently, the Abbey's designated it off-limits. If there's a Therian around, it's probably there.
I'm going to draw it out. If this is a trap, things may turn violent. Either way, this place is about to get a lot less tranquil.
The same as everywhere else I've been.
You can quit here if you like, but I'm going to keep on fighting the Abbey.
And if I try to stop you, you'll insist, I presume.
Velvet! No!
I'll give you one day. Once you've made up your mind, come meet me at the Cape.
I'm with him. How tomorrow shakes out depends on what you decide, Velvet.
Your hand. It's...
As you can see, I'm a demon. 3 years ago, I was the one who attacked this village and...
I don't want to hear it! Demon, or no demon, you're still you! Okay, so you're scary! I'll get used to it. I promise, I'll keep it a secret. Let's just live here in the village like we used to, okay? You, me, and everyone else.
Nico.
That was rather good, Velvet.
Yeah. Lafayette gets a gold star for being such a good taste tester, too!
Tomorrow, I'll fix you up a nice stew.
Hey, is this... It's the original copy of the book on Enominat! And all the pages are here! Velvet!
Hey, Fee. Can I borrow your compass real quick? I'll give it right back. Please?
All right.
He really wanted a compass, more than anything else. Just like you, he loved to stare out at the sea, wondering what's on the other side. He wanted to go adventuring someday.
Oh, I didn't know that.
I bet once he wakes up, you two will be really good friends.
So, this is what your life used to be like before everything happened, huh?
What's gotten into you? Maybe I made the pudding a little too sweet.
Velvet, how do you know what it tastes like?
I think I'll get myself some shut-eye.
But what are you going to do about tomorrow?
Mogulu, are there arts that let the caster manipulate dreams?
Huh? Dreams? Why?
There is, yes, an art that requires a certain type of Malak. It envelops you in a fog and reads your regrets, then traps you in a happy dream.
An art that reads your regrets and shows you happiness. I'm going to the Cape.
Now? What on earth's gotten into you?
Velvet!
Don't go.
Stay here.
Stay with me.
This is Fee's compass. I'm sorry, Luffy.
No, don't. Wait. Velvet, wait. Don't leave me here.
I love you, Velvet.
Is this what Mogilu was talking about?
We're going to the Cape Shrine. It's time to drag out the Therian.
Like I snapped at her when she was finally able to taste.
Mm-hmm.
She's like, bullshit.
Velvet!
There you are.
Velvet, you have to stop your friends. They keep saying they're going to the Cape, and they just won't listen.
The Abbey's forbidden anyone from going inside. We'll all be punished if anyone breaks the rules.
I hate to say it, Nico, but I think I'm a terrible person. I really thought I could have my old life back again, and I could forget everything else. I tried to act like I was doing it for Luffy, but it was all for myself. But I can't forget. I shouldn't forget. Luffy is dead. He was murdered without even knowing why. I will never forgive that. Ever! So get out of my way. If you don't, I'll devour you again!
Velvet. Why? Why must you do this? There we go. The truth at last.
Okay, okay.
Well, cover me, surprise.
I didn't think you'd actually tough it out.
What are you talking about?
Focus on the monsters, sweetie pie.
That's what I want to know. She knows some troops.
This way! The shrine's through these woods!
Hey, mind telling me what the hell's going on?
It's a trap. Trap, trap, trap. Our enemy spun an illusion based on Velvet's dreams.
That's a nasty little art.
But Velvet saw through it all?
She did. But even if it's all a dream, such brutality on her part.
Velvet's always been our brutal poodle. But to shake off the dream by herself, now that's something. The boundary between dreams and reality is demarcated solely by one's own heart.
What?
I'm saying she's wowie zowie cool beans. Come on, we gotta hurry.
She's wowie cool beans, we gotta hurry. Earmuffs. That's what we're waiting for. Those earmuffs.
Scout ship set.
This is awesome.
It was all a dream. Hell, even if it wasn't,
I won't turn back.
Oh, it seems like we can slide down there after we get the little thing over there. Oh my god, no!
I'll finish this now! Come on, really?
Okay, I got like two fire attacks on the same button. Can you go to the what's it called, please? And go to circle. And go to the last one. Yeah, click on it. Let's see.
One of your new ones is some.
There.
There we go. What's that?
I'll show you the beauty of my spear work.
Planet! I am Captain Planet! Captain Planet! He's a hero! Gonna fall! He's gonna kick your butt! He's gonna kick your butt!
I had no problems here.
Now you had hit with my freaking ice daggers, bitch, so you need to calm down. Oh. Finish what? Which one?
That one.
Sorry, pups. You're coming with me.
Velvet!
It's okay. I killed their owner. I deserve all their hate. And then some. But not now. Understand? Once I get my revenge, you can tear me apart if you like. I promise. Until then, I'll need your help.
Guess the art finally evaporated.
The book! It disappeared!
What book?
I found a copy of the ancient book with every page still intact. It was in Velvet's house.
Artorias' book! The real one might still be there. We should go back to Velvet's house to search for it.
That was one hell of an illusion. I have to admire the skill that went into its construction.
The caster probably has a tethered Malak with a unique power on the same level as my Reaper's curse. I can think of one person who would lay such a wicked trap.
Still, we may have a new clue to the nature of Innominaut. You've found Innominaut's book, right, Lafayette?
Yeah, in Velvet's house.
Then let's hurry to Velvet's house.
Oh look, there's the ghost creature.
Woo! It's a biggie!
Roaring thunder! 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 Spirit police! You wronged me! Here's your justice! Fighting order!
Wounds I won't heal! Pardon this left!
Grateful pain! Crushing blammo!
There's nobody here.
This is reality.
Yeah, I'm shocked that the place is still looking intact.
Mm-hmm.
It's empty.
No surprise there. Artorias is too thorough to overlook something like that.
If only I'd showed it to you as soon as I found it.
Don't beat yourself up over it. We wouldn't have been able to read it without Grimoire anyhow. It was just a dream. All of it.
This was your room, wasn't it? You can knit.
I was trying to learn. Nico said she'd teach me how as a thank you for giving her my quiche recipe. We wanted to finish a set of scarves for the winter.
Velvet.
Forget about it. I don't need to knit anymore.
Yes. I think it was one in that brother's room.
Check out all these complicated-looking books.
A hand
hand-drawn map.
Nice. It's incomplete, but seems quite detailed.
It's beautiful.
My brother drew it every day. Even when his fever got too strong for him to read a book, he'd stare at that map for hours.
Laffy said he wanted to travel the world?
Yes, it was his dream. I never understood what made him want to do something so dangerous. But I'm living his dream now. It's ironic, isn't it?
What a sad ending.
Those are the graves of my sister and her son. He died before he was even born.
They're in rough shape. We should lay some flowers.
Don't bother. There's no point.
A keen insight. Eating one would be cruel enough, but plucking an innocent flower just to offer it as decoration for some memorial. That's not even a sacrifice, just a cruelty devoid of all purpose.
Melchior!
As obtuse as ever.
I take it you're the one behind the dream fog?
I must say, you did well to break such resolve. If you weren't a Therian, I'd be tempted to take you under my wing.
Did you come here to flatter me?
Indeed. Although I was already in the neighborhood to retrieve this book.
I'll be taking that.
This book was compiled by my dear friend, who was also Artorius's mentor and predecessor as head of the Exorcists. It contains the hopes and dreams left by a noble soul who gave his life for the world that grieved him. It is not for a tainted demon to touch.
Like we need your permission!
Look who obeyed me for once.
Is that... You didn't!
Be patient. You'll know everything before long. What we seek is the realization of a perfect order, as tranquil and beautiful as a wildflower in bloom.
A perfect order? Let's go. There's nothing left for us here. Oh.
What's with Magaloo and the fat guy?
Oh, look! It's the book of Enominot.
What's it doing there? Wait, that's one of Arthur's.
Actually, it's a copy that Laffy set made.
Laffy made a copy of the book. He transcribed it all by hand, and then he sold it, just to buy me that comb.
There was something here for us after all.
Laffy.
If that's the complete manuscript, we might be able to unravel Enominot's secrets.
We'll have to show it to Grimoire.
Pulling one over on the old man, are you? Never a dull moment with Lady Calamity around.
Was she his assistant? That's what it seemed like.
Alright, time to drop off the pups and get Grimoire to translate this book. We're going back to Titania.